Hi, welcome everyone. So today we will be talking about the tables and advanced formatting in Microsoft Word. Alright, so these are all the steps we're going to be taking today, from creating the table down to the font alignment. So we're going to start with creating the table. How can we create a table? We're just going to go to the insert. See the table right here? You click on it, then this pops out. Now looking at this, when we select, okay, let's say we want a table that is 4 by 3. So this is 1, 2, 3, and 4, and this is 1, 2, 3. Now this is it right here, 4 by 3. So now for it to be there, I just need to click and it is now here. So that is how we can actually create a table. So we also have different table styles. Coming here, you see the different table styles. Now this is showing because we are on our design and we are on the table. If I should come here, it's not there, but if I should come back here, it comes out. So we can select any table style of our choice. We have so many table styles here, so you can select any one of your choice. So we're just going to leave it at the one. We're just going to leave it here. All right, now moving inside the table, how do we move inside the table? That is this cursor here. How can we move it from this cell to this one, to this, and to the rest of that? How do you do that? By just clicking on your tab, the tab key on your keyboard. Just click on the tab, it moves. Click again to move. Now, if you want to go back, you just hold your shift and click on the tab, goes back, back, back. Now, I want to go forward, just click on the tab, 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 keeps going forward. So that is how we can actually move inside a table. Now, how about deleting the rows and columns? Now, let's start by deleting our column. I'm just going to click here. Now, I've selected all the columns here. Now, if I want to delete it, I just right-click and I'll see delete columns. Deleted. Now, how about deleting the rows? The same thing. Just come here, select this. Okay, I'm going to highlight it. How I highlighted it, I left-clicked and drag. Then, I right-click, delete cells. Now this will pop up, which they are trying to get which you want to delete. So I want to delete the row. Deleting the entire row does not mean deleting everything, but the one I actually selected, I hit OK and it has deleted it. So that is how we can delete the rows and columns. Now, how can we insert our rows and columns? We've seen how we can delete them, so how can we insert it? It's so easy. Come here, you see the plus icon here. Just click on it, we've added. Now how about this side? I come here, I see the plus icon, I click on it, it add. If I click on it again, keep adding, and that is how we can insert our rows and columns. Alright, now how can we increase and decrease cell heights or widths? There are different ways of doing this. Now, when I come to the line here, this pops out. The cursor actually changed to this, and looking at this, looking at the arrow there, it's showing that you can either take it up or down. So I'm just going to left click and drag down or up. So I can just take it here and I'll leave it here, same as this. Click, can drag it this way or this way. So that is how we can actually increase. So another way is, while I'm typing in here, while I'm typing, if I go down, type, go down, keep increasing, go down, type, so I can actually increase it this way too. So those are some of the ways we can increase and decrease cell height and width. Now, which other way? Clicking here, go to the layouts. Now you see the height, you see the width. So now the height, let me increase it. Now this is it. How about the width? Increasing it like this. So these are the three ways you can actually increase or decrease your cell height or width. Now we want to talk about splitting cells. What does it mean to split cells? It actually means maybe creating more tables in a cell. Now let's split this. I click here, I come to split cells, and this pops out. Now how many columns and how many rows do I want in this cell? Let's say I want 5 and 3. 5 columns and 3 rows. Just click OK, and this is it. So I created a cell or a table in a cell. So that is how the split cells actually works. Now moving over to the merge cells. Merge cells is joining two or more cells together. So I'm going to merge this. I click here, I highlight to here, then I come to merge cells and I click on merge cells. Now this is it. So no matter what I'm typing, if I keep typing, it just continues because the cells are joined together. So that is what it means by merging cells together. All right, so now how about borders and shading? Talking about borders and shading, all right, let's say I want a shading here. I'll click here, go to my design, go to shading, and I can select any shade color. I click, and this is it. So if I want it here, come to the shading, I click, it's there. Come here, can click, can give it any color of your choice. It all depends on you, which color you want. Now this is what it means for the shading, borders and shading. Now talking about the borders, we've talked about this if you've been following our class. Now this is the borders. Now I'm going to click on this, I'm going to click on all borders. Now this is it. So if I want for everything, I just click here, selected everything, go to all borders and click, and now it's having all borders. Now this border, if you look at it very well, it's having double lines and it's orange. We can actually change it to a single line and also change the color by coming here to the border styles. Click here, I can select this one and it. Now this is actually going to take time because I'm going to be clicking, clicking and clicking. So this is one, this is how this actually works, like that and all of that. So if I want the pen color, just come here, click, and I can change it to this. So apply here, apply here. So this is how the border styles and the pen colors works. It talks about more of the borders. Alright, finally, we'll be talking about the font alignment. Now, the font alignment is either aligning your text or your fonts at the center, the bottom, the top, the right corner, the left corner, the left bottom or the right bottom, the left or the right. Now how can we do that? Now let's say we are having a text here. Now let's say we are having this here. I'll just go to my layout, that is after I'm still selecting the YouTube. I'll go to the layout. Now I want it center aligned. I'll come to this one, align center. Click, it's aligned at the center. Now if I want it left center align, I just click on this there. Now if I also want it at the bottom right align, I click here. So I'm just going to leave it here, and this is how you can actually align your fonts in your table. So this is all we are going to be taking for today. So today we've talked about the tables and the advanced formatting. See you guys in our next class, and stay safe.